Hi everyone. Hi. I guess I should take a seat for this. This is going to be a video about something new that I've been introduced to, that I'd like to share some information about a goal, or not even just a goal, an idea, something to support one another. And it's called PayPal me. So, give me 2 seconds, please, and I will be back. In the meantime, keep your horses put. I don't know where that came from. Hold on 1 second. Keep your horses put. Is that even like a real saying? I'm not even sure. Okay. Wow, my lips look like I just ate someone. And so yeah, let's get this off of me because I get hot and colds and stuff on a regular basis. It has to do with my physical constitution. My body is made up literally. The most dominant element that my body is made up of is fire. Every human individual has all the elements within their body, but mine is the most dominant is fire. I've studied Ayurvedic medicine as well as oils. And when it comes to Ayurveda, I am the Pitta constitution, and I hardly wear any more face makeup. Like, I'll wear lipstick and stuff, which, like I said, I just had lunch, and so it looks like my lips, it looks like I literally ate someone. And like my face looks inflamed, but like I said, it's just the whole fire thing. Speaking of that, since this video is about PayPal me, I'm just gonna hold on to this because I like to do that. It's a crystal quartz. So PayPal me, I was recently introduced to, of course, as you know, I receive online payments through PayPal. And like for readings and healings and anything of that nature. And if you've been watching me recently or even longer than that, I'm all about community work. Okay, I've been in community work almost all my life. Some of it been paid for, some of it was voluntary, but I just feel on a natural level it's where I thrive the most. I find in today's age and today's society could really benefit in advancing when it comes to communities right now. Because a lot is shifting, a lot is changing. The youth does not resonate on these old institutions anymore, okay? So, because it is really difficult to get and to create like some sort of organization, which would probably be, I don't know, like something I've always wanted to do. But like I said, it can be difficult, especially when the people who are supporting you or would like to support you are living abroad and they're living far from you. They're not in your town, they're not in your country. So how is it possible, to create a solid structure, like a physical building, when everybody else is like scattered around? So I find, there's always crowdfunding for funding like any type of event. Or funding like an artist, a musician, or an idea, or creating something individually or as a community as a whole. But I find some people are put off with crowdfunding because either A, they're not quite sure where their idea will lead them to, if it will be successful, and some people that are supporting the crowdfunding and actually. Yeah, so I was saying that are actually paying or funding the crowdfund or whatever it is. They're not quite sure what it is that they're paying for and where it's actually going to go, if that makes sense. Like, if it's actually going to be used for a specific reason or that specific reason that's listed. So, which is why I'm feeling PayPal Me is something interesting. There is another option on PayPal that a lot of people are doing, and even readers or like other type of healers and like life coaches, I've seen that they're receiving, and even like radio shows, like they accept PayPal through emails. But the only thing that is kind of a turn off for me when it comes to that is if you're not quite sure who the person is that you're paying, but you're interested in what it is that they have to offer, it doesn't look all that professional when you're just sending them. You know what I mean? Like it's an email you're just basically sending it to, and they're just sending you like a receipt with PayPal. It doesn't tell you what it is that you're paying for. So that is why I think I feel PayPal Me is something interesting that I've been feeling out, and I'm liking it. With PayPal Me, you create your it's for people who have an interest, I guess, in creating like something. So what I'm trying to get at is basically when I'm gonna link up my link to my PayPal Me account or link, and it's just like a page. It's got my picture on there. It's got a little bit of a bio on there, and then you just put in however much you want to put in. And I find that much more attractive in terms of you know where it's kind of going, you know, the money where it's going. So I think what I'm gonna do with this PayPal Me account or link, sorry, is I just feel at this moment in time, like I said, my intention is to create a community of like-hearted, like-minded individuals coming together to create, to support, you know, to educate, to, you know, to also support and to empower the youth, women, men, all walks of life that are experiencing any type of trauma, alienation when it comes to society, igniting their spiritual aspects, and the list goes on. Shamans, witches, healers, guides, everyone, everything, anybody who's really open to learning more about themselves and the world as a whole. I feel like this is something where people who are really determined to help, like, you know, educate and help as many people as they can. I know there's a lot of this stuff going around on a global scale, and a lot of people are offering this for free, so why should I receive any type of compensation? But I really would like people to know that I'm not expecting millions of dollars. I'm not expecting hundreds of dollars from each person. You can pay as little as a few dollars to as high as to however much you'd like. It's just a gift, it's a donation, it's a support to get an idea off the ground and to see where it can go, to see where it can lead. I cannot control the outcome. I cannot control other people doing the work, putting in the work and telling them how to do things, telling them how to run things. But what I can do is keep doing what I'm doing to support people's paths, to keep supporting people feel loved and supported when, you know, their families are not supporting them, or when they're going through homelessness, or if they're going through this, if they're going through that, any of it, you know what I mean? So I just feel like in return, it's just giving me something to stabilize. I don't know, you want to call it my feet, you want to call it my root, like just a little something so I can kind of just keep going with it. And just see where it can lead me and see where it can lead as a community, okay? Because my intention is not to keep the money to myself. I mean, sure, I'd probably take a bit of it, but my intentions is to do this with people who have suffered what I've suffered, and to create a, like I said, a community online, and just and maybe eventually it would be into a physical. I don't know. I can't say right now, but What I'm offering with this right now, like I said, if you're open to just giving a few dollars, I would totally accept. I'm completely non-judgmental about whatever it is, any situation. And what I'd like to give back to the community for giving back to me is a full moon, December the 25th. Closing of cycles, past cycles, ceremony. Okay. So this is going to be a really protective ceremony involving earth magic, involving high magic, involving white crystalline energies combining with the earth. So again, coming back to the number 8 and the 13 unite, energetic and physical combined. And it's just going to be a really protective, therapeutic healing. All I ask is for you to kindly give something. And if you'd like to be part of the ceremony, please either comment below this video with that you'd like to be in there, and I could just put in your name, or you can give me your name, or you can send me an email if you don't want anybody to know about this other than me. So the link to my email is heal@redearthgoddess.com, and you can send me an email there, and give me your name, and you'll be added to the ceremony. So the ceremony is going to be outdoors in a forest in the daytime, December 25th. And again, it's going to be very protective to usher in 2016 so that everything good can come in for your path, for your career, for relationships, and letting go of the past and just being protected in all areas, in all directions as a whole, okay? I think that's all I want to say again. And the link is paypal.me/redearthgoddess. And Red Earth Goddess is literally one word next to the slash, okay? So this is what I'm doing for now. Again, I mentioned before, there is an idea that I may get back into 360 Kids. And that would probably be for like about 5 weeks in January. It's not 100%, so I don't want to get too much into that. But even if I was to get into that and devote over 40 hours of my time a week there, I'm still devoted to you guys. I'm still devoted to my spiritual community on the web, and global healing as a whole. And again, seeing how we can work together, seeing how us working together will continue to grow. Okay, so this gives us this time right now to really see how well we can do this. It's not a test, but So on that note, here is something a little special. Me with all my framed animal insect goods. But I thought I'd bring this out because it suits what I'm wearing. It's got a beautiful green wing, rainbow-like, green and pink. Kind of matches me and my tattoos, eh? The green peacock feather, the roses, and the leaves, and what I'm wearing because I'm wearing green. So in previous videos, I think I mentioned this to be a moth, but I am so sorry. Excuse me, spirit here. It's actually a grasshopper. I don't know how I mix up moth and grasshopper, but this is a Phimatus saxosus, if I hope I'm saying that correct, from Madagascar. This locust is more commonly known as the rainbow milkweed locust. Its colorful exterior is both beautiful and harmful. And I don't mean to scare people, but the laws of nature, I mean, nature, it's just the way it goes. So the rainbow hues seen on a Phimatus Saxosis, if I'm saying that right, Saxosis warns predators, both animal and human, that is highly poisonous. That it is highly poisonous. Excuse me for my English reading. Born in Canada, can't read for shit. this is a result of its diet of toxic milkweed. Threaten this grasshopper and it will produce a poisonous froth from beneath its wings, okay? So I find humans are similar to these things, to these beautiful creatures, because we are creatures in a sense. But I just realized I match with the curtain too. Yeah, you know, we are creatures. We are the creatures of this earth because we are, we have a physical body. Our physical bodies are of this earth. In a beautiful, wonderful world, we would all get along, animals, humans, insects, everything. But humans are here to develop this evolution in their own space, in their own time, all at different paces. We allow things, we allow us to work together if we choose. And for those that this message resonates with, you get what I mean. So, PayPal me, and this is not even just for me, like I said, my intention is to give back to you guys, and why don't you guys create your own accounts? Totally sign up with PayPal, and create a link of your own, and even send it to me, okay? So, love you, mwah, mwah, and talk soon, guys. Bye!